In this tutorial, we will show how to do a flim fit. So we first open the sample workspace and select the daisy pollen file as an example of a flim image and apply the flim script. So now the data is basically loaded into the flim script. We get a new window. In this window, we have here the image options, the image itself, display options. For example, the lifetime is shown as a color code. Here is still the fast lifetime. We have the lifetime histogram, so the distribution of the fast lifetime over the different pixels. We have the TCSB CDK and the fitting options. So in the fitting options, we choose a reconvolution model with the estimated IRF in this case. We can open the help file. If you're unsure about what the parameters mean, you can check it here in this window. And now we can click on to initial fit to do a first flim fit of the complete decay, and then you see that this is not really a decent fit, so we can increase the number of relevant parameters. Let's increase the number of fitting parameters to 3. If you look now on a single pixel basis, you see that it's difficult to fit a 3 exponential fit into each of these pixels because there's simply not enough photons in each pixel. What we can do in this case is we can sacrifice a little bit spatial resolution by doing a 2x2 pixel binning and updating the image. Now we basically add always 4 pixels into one, and then we can see that the decay has now one new pixel has m significantly more photons. Still, in order to do a decent flim fit, we have to fix a few parameters, so shift and background of the IRF, for example. We can also fix the background of the decay to 0, as on a single pixel basis it will be very low, and we fix also the lifetime components in this case to make for demonstration. Now we want to know what is the background. So here we see that we have about a few hundred photons in the background and a few thousand photons in the pollen. So we can set the threshold to 1000 and then start the flim fit. So what the flim fit does, it now fits in every pixel that has more than 1000 counts this 3 exponential model with the 3 fixed lifetimes, and the estimated IRF, which is used for the reconvolution in this case because we didn't define it otherwise. As a result, a similar image is displayed as before. The only difference is mainly that now on the lifetime area we have now tau average int plotted, so the intensity weighted average lifetime instead of the fast lifetime. We also have now can go switch to the RGB model and show the intensity of each lifetime component in a different color. So we can, for example, say that the first component is mainly present in the rim. Can also just turn it off to see whether there's anything beyond, and we see that we have also a little bit of the intensity of component 2. In the each of these components is also presented here in the lifetime histogram. As we fix the individual lifetimes, we have these sharp stripes here, and the average lifetime is then plotted as the back line below. Okay, we can save this result, get a new file with the fitting parameters, close this file, and have finished.